The Norwegian oil and gas operator DNO has reaffirmed its interest in the fellow Kurdistan producer Gulf Keystone Petroleum, but at a lower asking price than its previous offer. Their $300 million cash and shares offer expired after Gulf Keystone rejected their bid due to ongoing financial restructuring. Well, I'm joined on the line now by Cantor Fitzgerald's oil analyst Sam Wahab. Sam, thanks for joining us. What more do we know about the untangling here of this potential deal?
Well, as we know, back in July, DNO offered a $300 million cash and shares offer. At the time, GKP were obviously undergoing their own financial restructuring. That seems to look like it's at the conclusion now. They've also done an open offer of $25 million. So at towards the end of last month, I think they're boasting a cash position of $109 million with only a net debt with a debt position of $100. In terms of DNO, I think they're really playing down the value of Shaikan as an asset, which comes across as slightly contrived, in my opinion, given that if they didn't believe it to be a good producer, they wouldn't be coming back to the table looking to acquire it again.
What do you reckon they've based this lower offer on?
Well, in their Q3 results, they said that they had uncertainties over the asset itself, their commercial outlook, and the future rights and obligations at the Shaikan field. I think, as I say, that they're looking to play down the long-term value. That could be stemming from issues in country with the payment cycle, but DNO also suffers from the same irregular payment mechanism. I believe they're just trying to be acquisitive, play down the assets, and try and get it for a lower value.
As you mentioned there, they've got concerns around the uncertainty of the asset and commercial outlook. Are those concerns justified, do you reckon?
Well, I think there always has been an element of concern over the Shaikan field, given that before they didn't realise that there was aquifer support in the geology, and therefore they didn't know quite how many wells they'd need to drill to reach plateau production. I think the understanding from Gulf Keystone has improved of the asset, but there still are uncertainties because the company has had to reduce the amount of drilling that they've done on the field due to financial constraints.
Sam, do you know they've recently published their third quarter results? What kind of shape are they in at the moment?
They seem to be in a very good shape, you know, especially bearing in mind that they're receiving irregular payments from the Kurdish regional government, and also the payments from back costs are actually very low. So they've got $266 million of cash, $134 million of debt, so reasonably low gearing for the type of company. And that would support an all-cash offer, but it would be well below the $300 million, as I say, before. But they're also diversified on a geographical level, unlike Gulf Keystone, so they've got production arising from Oman, albeit quite small at 5,000 barrels. But they're looking in relatively strong shape, any uptick in the oil price, and would obviously improve matters.
From what you can gather, are there any other potential acquirers out there for Gulf Keystone?
Well, one thing for investors to bear in mind is that the IOCs generally can't invest in Kurdistan because part of the oil law in the country is that you can't produce from the south of the country as well as a semi-autonomous region. So that really puts a stumbling block on the likes of BP or Exxon, for example. Other companies, maybe some of the state-owned Asian companies like CNPC would make sense, but I think that it would be those sort of companies rather than any of the major blue chip names.
So what would your message be here for investors in Gulf Keystone? Should they be concerned?
Well, I think having interest in the company and in the asset itself could be a good thing that could drive future value. But I think DNO are intentionally downplaying the value of Shaikan to hopefully get it at a lower price. I think in terms of management, the noises they seem to be making, they want to stick with the outlook. They want to continue to grow production at Shaikan. They're producing at 33,000 barrels a day at the moment. That's quite material for a company of this size. And the outlook is that they'll keep on drilling and working over so that they can ramp up production.
Great to speak to you, Sam. Thanks for taking the time.
Thank you.